Welcome back. 680 News Senior Business Editor Mike Eppel joins us now. Good morning, Mike.
Hello, how are you?
I'm good, can't complain. How are you?
I'm good, thank you.
Good to hear. Okay, let's talk about a big conversation here. The U.S. delays the reopening of the border to Canadian travelers to August 21st, while Canada is set to allow fully vaccinated Americans to cross on August 9th.
Yeah, this came as a bit of a surprise because all of the talk about the reopening of the Canada-U.S. border was supposed to be about coordination.
Mm-hmm.
And at the end of the day, we're reopening almost 2 weeks before the Americans, and it seems like there is no coordinated effort on the border reopening. And then you have to wonder about, okay, wait a second, their COVID numbers are way above ours now. It's like,
yeah.
Who should be reopening first, perhaps?
Yeah, good point.
But look, this is a huge business aspect for the tourism industry on both sides of the border. There, you know, New York State has been actually pushing the Biden administration to reopen to Canadian travelers much sooner than this. So this is another delay for, anybody who wants to cross the border to maybe go see family who live in the United States. They haven't been able to do so, at least not on the land crossings, for more than a year here. But look, at the end of the day, the talk was, again, about making it easy as possible, whether it's through the Travel Canada app, which we have. The U.S. doesn't seem to have any equivalent.
Mm-hmm.
And are you going to get bottlenecks because there's going to be, people waving their vaccine certificates and then the border guards have to deal with this and send people back if they're not fully vaccinated? I mean, all of this should be done through a pre-check, and we have the technology to do it. It's just a matter of, actually doing it and putting it in place.
Speaking of technology, something new I learned. There's a global computer chip shortage, and the auto industry, General Motors, is set to shut down production of its biggest money makers. What's that all about?
Yeah, pickup trucks.
Mm-hmm.
Going to be offline next week for the foreseeable future here. And this has been something that's been going on for months now, Fiza, in the auto industry or any sector that requires, computer chip components. And, cars and trucks are basically computers on wheels nowadays. And General Motors pickup trucks and SUVs, that's where their profit margins are. And if they're not building that, that's going to be a dent to the earnings. And you go on and just drive around. Look at the dealership lots. There's limited inventory, new cars and trucks, or used cars and trucks. And that's why prices have gone up in some cases. For used cars, more than you paid a year ago. It's a remarkable dynamic in the marketplace right now.
So we're seeing more people going back to sports stadiums and live events in the U.S., and Coca-Cola is benefiting from that.
Yeah, they sure are, and they're sounding really optimistic about their earnings because, let's face it, they're selling a lot of soft drink and snack foods, and PepsiCo said the same thing last week about the reopening of the United States. You look at sporting events and concerts and everything else going on stateside right now. That's a huge moneymaker for these companies, and that's part of the reason why the markets have gone up over the past couple of days. We had that sell-off Monday back up for the past couple of days because corporate earnings have been strong. Whirlpool, the appliance maker, this morning just said, hey, they're selling washers and dryers like never before, and it's keeping up with demand. That's the biggest problem right now.
Okay, I don't know how you feel about this, but I'm enjoying the working from home life. I enjoy business up top, maybe pajamas down at the
shorts,
bottom.
Shorts, khaki shorts.
I'm just going to throw that out
there. I'm not even going to subject
the viewers
to that. Why don't you
stand up and show us what you're wearing right now?
My word for it, I'm wearing shorts. That's as far as we're going. But yeah, what is party of the front, business at the back? Anyway, that's my hair. The latest survey indicating when we're getting back to work, people are not going to be wearing necessarily suits and ties. This is a big thing for the fashion industry to adapt to the pandemic casual, I've dubbed it.
Yes.
Getting back to the office. Not wearing, pajamas or anything like that, but comfortable clothing and, dressing down a little bit because people have gotten used to that.
Who doesn't want to be comfortable?
I'm still not sold on shorts and sandals of the office, but that's another debate.
I mean, I wouldn't mind a little fashion show for us just to kind of show us what
it's
you're
just,
working
you
with.
Don't, it's too early. Way too early for such things.
We don't want to go there.
Don't
what you're
need
saying.
To see my knobby knees.
You know what? I'm back in tomorrow. Maybe we can have a look tomorrow then.
Okay.
Who knows? I get the feeling that you're a fashion forward kind of guy, so.
Oh, yeah, that's me.
We can all learn from you.
That's how I've always been described, yeah, fashion forward.
Okay. Mike Eppel, thank you so much. I'll chat with you tomorrow.
Later. Okay.
And we're learning more about how the pandemic is affecting Team Canada showing at tomorrow's Olympic opening ceremony. Details on that next.